Greet you, YouTubers. Here is the guy with a Swiss accent, with a new episode around sensors and microcontrollers. In video number 131, we pimped our Raspi. One of the new features was a cooling fan, which switched automatically on if the CPU temperature was too high. Viewers suggested to make the speed of the fan variable. And this is what we will do today. We also will learn a few things about pulse width modulation, PID controllers, MOSFET transistors, and even a little of magic. So let's start. In video number 131, I used a simple concept, a MOSFET transistor to switch the fan on and off, and a Python program which measures the CPU temperature and switches the MOSFET. Very simple. I used a beefy IRLC44N transistor because it is logic level. In video number 137, I showed that these FETs switch on at a voltage of below 2.5 volt. This is why they are ideal for microprocessors with 3.3 volt logic. First, let's do some tests on the breadboard. I used the same diagram as in the last video, and we see that the fan starts to run full speed if we connect the gate of the transistor to 3.3 volt. And it switches off if we connect the gate to ground. I connect now a button between 3.3 volt and the gate to switch the voltage. As soon as I push the switch, the fan starts to run. Unfortunately, the fan continues to run even if I open the switch. Not what we expected, right? So let's measure the gate voltage to check if I made a wiring mistake. If we look at the oscilloscope, we see that the gate voltage is 0 volts. But we also see that as soon as I connected the probe, the fan stopped. Magic? Let's try again. And this time I leave the probe connected because we want to see the truth. The voltage really switches between 0 and 3.3 volt. But the fan now behaves differently. It does exactly what we want. It switches on and off. Great! But what happened? The explanation is somehow hidden. But we get a clue if we look very close to this curve. The signal is not a clean rectangle. When we open the contact, it does not go immediately to zero. It has a curve, which is typical for the discharge of a capacitor. Maybe there is somewhere a capacitor? Yes, there is a capacitor between the gate of the MOSFET and ground. And if we leave the gate open, this capacitor stays charged. The gate voltage stays high and the transistor stays on. What happened then when we connected the probe? Each probe of an oscilloscope has an input resistance. As soon as I connected the probe to the gate, the capacitor was discharged and the transistor switched off. By the way, this behavior is completely different compared with a bipolar NPN transistor and is typical for a field effect transistor. To prove my point, I replace the FET transistor with a 1 nanofarad capacitor. And you see, its behavior is very similar. Of course, it does not switch the fan. And if we have a look into the datasheet of the transistor, we find the value of this capacitance too. So best practice is to connect a resistor between gate and ground, in parallel to this capacitance. In our case, the Raspi GPIO has quite a low resistance. So this resistor is already built in, and we do not need to add an additional one. For the next step, we have to know the maximum speed of the fan. It is about 7800 RPM at 5 volt. As we saw, I can switch the fan on and off. If I do this fast, then the fan cannot get to its full speed anymore, and it does not have time to stop completely. some of you know that I still know the Morse code. But this switching is too exhausting even for me. So I replace my finger and connect a waveform generator to the gate. It switches the voltage every 0.5 seconds on and off. What happens? The RPM starts to fluctuate and the meter shows around 4000 RPM. If I reduce the percentage of the on time to 20%, the fan has the time to go to a complete stop and the meter shows around 1000 RPM, obviously with a lot of fluctuation. It is easy to reduce this fluctuation. We just increase the switching frequency of the signal to, let's say, 10 Hz. Now there is no more fluctuation and the meter shows a more or less constant 1000 RPM. If I increase the duty cycle to 50% again, we get around 4000 RPM, which is 50% of the maximum of 7800. Very good. With this system, we obviously can vary the speed of the fan, and we can use a digital 3.3 volt signal to do so, which fits exactly the possibilities of our Raspi. If we increase the frequency even more, nothing special happens. Only if we zoom to the edge of the curve, we see that the voltage goes higher than 5 volt. In our situation, this is not dangerous, because our MOSFET can handle that. But in other situations, where we switch coils, this voltage can get much higher, and we can even destroy the transistor. Fortunately, there is a simple trick available. We connect a diode, preferably a fast Schottky type, in parallel to the coil, or in our case, the fan. And now, this overshooting is gone. Another thing I have to mention if we drive MOSFETs with PWM signals. Charging and discharging the gate capacitor draws current from the driving pin. The higher the frequency, the higher the average current, because a capacitor behaves like a short circuit at high frequencies. This is why you have to add a protection resistor between the GPIO and the gate. This resistor limits the current. Today we only use very low frequencies, so this is not too dangerous for our Raspi and I did not implement one. Now our hardware is ready. Let's go to the software. In video number 131, we already had a software which started automatically at boot up, reads the temperature and switches the fan. So we use exactly this software and add a few lines. First, we have to be able to generate a pulsed signal. This is also called PWM or Pulse Width Modulation signal. Fortunately, the Raspberry Pis can create such a signal at their GPIO pins. We use Python for our program to control the fan. In Python, the command to enable PWM on a pin is as follows. The fan pin is the pin number and 50 is the PWM frequency. As we found out, the frequency is not so important for our application. That's why I choose 50 Hz. Now we can start the pin with the command start 50, where 50 is the duty cycle. If we later want to change the duty cycle, we have to use the command change duty cycle, fan speed, where fan speed is the variable for the duty cycle. Now we have nearly everything necessary to fulfill our task. The only missing part is how to determine how fast the fan should run. Let's assume we want a stable temperature of 45 degrees. Then we could measure the actual temperature and calculate the difference. Let's assume we measure 55 degrees. Then the difference is 10 degrees. And let's assume we want the fan at full speed at this temperature. Then we would have the following formula. Fan speed in percentage equals 10 times the difference between the two temperatures. Now let's assume the temperature difference gets smaller and smaller. Then, of course, the speed of the fan gets smaller and smaller. But unfortunately, the temperature will never exactly reach the 45 degrees, also because the fan will stop at about 10% duty cycle. This regulator is called P regulator because it is proportional. If we want to get a more precise control, we have to add an I part, an integration part. To achieve this, we sum up all differences between the desired and the actual temperature. If our fan stops at, let's say, 46 degrees, and we add the differences every second, this value adds up quickly and the fan starts to run, even with this small temperature difference. This is why I also implemented an I part in my program. If you watch my video number 28, you see the term PID controller. So there is one letter missing, the D or differential part. This part is used to get a faster reaction of the controller. This is important for self-balancing systems, for example. With our fan, speed of regulation is not so important. This is why I did not implement a D part. So, our controller is only called PI controller. Guys who followed the instructions from video number 131 and already have a fan implemented just need to get the improved program. All the others have to watch video number 131 first and follow the instructions there. Finally, we check if everything works. To do that, I switch the program off and the CPU temperature rises to 65 degrees. As soon as we start the program, the fan starts to run with 100% speed. The temperature starts to decrease and the fan also decreases its speed till we reach 45 degrees. Then the temperature oscillates around our desired temperature and the fan needs only 30 to 40% of its power to keep the temperature at this CPU load. It would immediately adapt its power if the CPU load would change. So we now have a quiet fan and a reasonable CPU temperature. I think this is really cool. So, summarized, we know now how to use PWM on a Raspi, and we also know how to properly drive a MOSFET transistor. And we programmed a simple PI controller. Fortunately, there was no magic, just a lack of understanding, as it is quite often in life. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, then like. Bye.